Welcome back to another badass video from Network Engineer Academy, and this is video number 10. So if you haven't watched any of the previous videos, make sure you go back and watch the previous videos. And so far, I've been so excited and sharing this information with you because, you know, the way that I've been walking you through and building this network, I know that for some of you, it's completely new, and probably for some others, it's like, you know, I knew this information, but now it makes a lot more sense. So yes, I think I feel more confident about those topics. And that's basically our goal, our objective, you know, to give you a lot of value, for you to become more valuable to the marketplace. And for you to, yes, to be a badass, high paid and successful network or systems engineer in the IT field. Now, going back to the network, right? So remember, on the previous video, we had this computer trying to say hello to this port and this router. And the router so far, yes, it's able to say, to get the hello, but what happens? It has no idea how to say hello back. And that's because the router has no idea, because on the routing table, that network, this network, it's not listed. And it makes sense because, I mean, the only two that are supposed to be on the routing table are the two networks that are directly attached to the router. Okay, so what I'm gonna walk you through is logging into the router and tell the router, hey, you know, if you wanna go back, if you wanna, you know, get back to that router, if you wanna say hello to any of the computers on that network, this is that way and how you can communicate back to that network. Okay, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do. So first, let me just to make sure, let me open this PC, right? Let me open that up. And let me, once again, I'm gonna ping, okay, the port and the router, that 10.10.102, just to make sure that it's not working, okay? And you know, by the way, this is what I'm gonna do too, okay? Request timeout. I'm gonna do a command where it's gonna, instead of trying four times, it's gonna keep trying and trying and trying. So once we do that change, we can see the difference, okay? So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna let that finish. Okay, so now I'm gonna do this, dash T, and bam. So now instead of trying to say hello, you know, four times, it's gonna keep going and going. So I'm gonna put that on the side right now, okay? So now I'm gonna go on this router, okay? And make sure you take notes. So I'm gonna do enable, config T, and this is the command, IP route, okay? And because I'm not a genius, I'm gonna do the question mark, right? And it's gonna tell me, oh, you need that destination. Oh yeah, it makes sense. Like basically the router is asking me like, hey, where is the destination, the IP that you want to trying to get to? And I'm like, well, I wanna communicate with this network 10.10.10.0. Okay, so what's next? I don't know, question mark. Oh, what's the subnet mask of that network? Oh, I know, 255.255.255.0. Okay, question mark, because I don't know what's next, right? And that's the Ethernet port, the loopback, the serial VLAN. Well, here, we're gonna use this, okay, the IP address. We can use the port, but we're gonna use the IP address. And here, it's basically saying, okay, you are not trying to get to this network, to the 10.10.10.0. Okay, but from like, where am I supposed to go once I want to connect to the network? And it makes sense to send it here because this router knows about this network because, yes, you know, that network is directly attached to this router. So if this router sends the packet back to him, he's gonna know what to do with it. And that's exactly what we are going to do. And we're gonna send it to this port. And remember, this port is 10.10.101. And that's exactly the IP that I'm gonna use. 10.10.101, okay? So before, you know, click enter, let me come up with this, you see? So this is the command that I did and it keeps going and going nonstop. But watch, once I click enter, what's gonna happen? So I'm gonna go here, and I'm gonna click enter, bam. So now the router knows about this network, so it's gonna be able to get back. So it's gonna take probably a few seconds, boom. You see, now probably this is new to you, like shit, you know, this is badass. Okay, because when I knew this like many years ago, I'm like, oh my God, this is good. You know, we're making some progress. Now I know. I see what's going on, you know, what happens in the background. And remember what I did. The only thing that I did on that router was like, hey, for you to get back, if you want to communicate with that network, this is the way for you to go to. Okay? So now we are getting that reply. Okay? So let me end that. So that's done. So right here, once again, I'm on this router. Remember, I'm on this router. So this is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to do this. Do show IP route. And boom! You see? We have a new entry, and this is S. The S, that means that's a static. A static meaning that someone put it in. Okay, now here in brackets, you know we have something that it's called the metric, and that's the last number, zero. And obviously, it's the metric, it's zero, because this network is directly attached to the router. Yes, so this is the router, so yes, it's directly connected. So that's why the metric is zero. The one, it's what they call the administrative distance, okay? Depending on also what type of dynamic protocol we use, that's the number, it gets higher. And that basically is that if the router knows like, okay, I can get to that network and I have three ways for me to get to that network. I have three ways, but you know, the best is with the administrative distance, you know, the lower the number, the better. So because this one is one, it's static, it's gonna go to that route. And that's a lot more that I can tell you about it, but I wanna make this video too long. I'm just giving you an idea, okay, about what this number means when you do like the static, okay? So that's it, this is how it works. Now, okay, if I want this computer to communicate all the way here with YouTube, guess what? I'm gonna have to go to each of those routers and tell her like how to get all the way here. So as you're probably thinking right now, like, whoa, it's gonna take a long time, Jorge. And yes, and this is just 3-4 routers. Imagine 50 routers. Yeah, that's a fucking nightmare. But the way that I'm gonna walk you through now in the next video, it's finally, yes, finally, you know, do some damage, some configuration with OSPF. Okay, and that's exactly what I'm gonna show you. That's exactly what I'm gonna walk you through on video 11. So make sure you go and watch video 11, and I'm gonna talk to you there.